Hello everyone and welcome back, and in this video we are going to talk about mutability in JavaScript. Before that, let's talk about one simple example, which is what will be the output of this. So we recently talked about the different primitive types, objects and all. So here what we are doing is we are just doing a summation of floating point numbers and trying to compare. So this will always returns false because these are the floating point numbers. The representation of these floating point numbers is extended. The expression evaluate above is implicitly read as this. Okay, so it's like a floating point expression, and this will be evaluated like this, and where the FPA function produces the floating point approximation number. So it's never going to be exactly 0.1 and 0.2. It can be like varied representation. In JavaScript there are no true integers. All numbers are implemented in the double precision in 64-bit binary format. So if you try to convert this decimal one into binary format, which can be endless, right? Like when you try to do 1 divided by 3, so how it comes like, okay, 0.33333333. So there is an endless representation of this, right, in base 10. But when you do the binary representation, you have to stop somewhere, and obviously when you are doing it, then obviously the difference will be there in the summation and they will never be equals. This is common in all programming language, I will say. Now coming to the immutability and mutability. So first of all, I will call about mutation. Mutation and immutability. Mutation means you have simple object function or something and you started doing a change on that. So this is my object I have. Okay. What I'm doing is, in this object I added a property. Okay. Then it's like I'm altering this object and trying to mutate this. So it is called mutability. One of the key differentiating attribute between the primitive data types and compound data type is that the formats are immutable. In recent video we talked about primitives, which is like a boolean, number, floating point, string and all, right? And then we talk about the objects, functions. So the only difference is the primitive types mostly are immutable. So like you talk about var x is 90. Now what you are doing is x is 80, right? So x was earlier 90, now x is 80. So what we are trying to say is, when we deal with the primitive data types, we don't have to deal with these mutability things, because you can assign the value. You created a character like x is c, and in the next statement you actually change this value to something else. So we have these two variables, hello and other greetings is some greetings, and both has the same value. Now if you change the some greeting to something else, the other greeting will still have the same value, right? We have these variables, some greeting, that contains the string value hello. These are primitive types. We also have a second variable, other greeting, pointing to the same string value. If we mutate the string value being pointed by these two variables, then we would expect both of these variables to reflect that change. So we try to do this by calling the transformative concat method. So this is simple example, like if you try to change this on one particular, like sumGreeting.concat, right? And we'll try to see the output of this by just printing these values again. Okay, so when we log the values of both some greeting and other greeting, neither has changed. This is because string are primitives and cannot be mutated. The concat method returned as a new string. So this is what I was talking about. When we talk about the primitives, they can't be mutated, right? And can't mutate it. So whenever you are actually trying to mutate them, obviously you will end up having a new variable. Okay, so this is just an example of concat, because if you want to store it, then it will return a new things and you can actually assign it to somewhere else. Okay, this is some string and these will not be altered, they will still hold the value hello. Okay, similarly we can see that in array you can actually alter a particular index. Okay, so similarly we can see the individual characters in a string can be accessed by index. However, we attempt to reassign one of those characters, it has no result on the overall string. So that we will see. Okay, so I have this some string. Okay, so the first character will be H and I'm reassigning the first character with this. So if you try to execute this and try to see, so the output is still A, still E, because at one index it's E, not H. So what we are trying to do is some string, right? We are trying to mutate the value of first index in this particular string, but if you try to print this again, then it is still holding the same value. This is clearing out our proof, right? Because string is primitives and it can't be, it is not mutable. Even if you try to change the index, it will still hold the same value, right? We call concat once more, this time using its return value to reassign to the some greeting. Okay, so let's see this. When we reassign this value to something else like some greeting and we are doing concat, right? So obviously now you are reassigning this to some variable which is here, some greeting. So some greeting will have this concat because now you have reassigned it. Some greeting was something else earlier, now you have reassigned to the output of this. So obviously it will be now changed, right? Now this is all about primitives, right? Now if you try to change, try to use this immutability in a compound type, which are like objects. So primitive types can't be mutated. But what about compound types? They certainly can be mutated. That is true. I mean, you have the object, you have the array. So this type of this is an array, right? Type of this is an object. And you can change the particular index value of this. So you can actually call the array.prototype.sort, array.prototype. Particular methods which are actually updating the array. If you try to use the array.prototype.map filter, then obviously they will not mutate the existing array, they will always return the new array. But when you talk about push, we push a new string to the array once more and we see that the array is mutated. I mean, this is an array of our favorite planets. If you try to do the dot push, you will get the new output having this value. Now next attempt, so consider that this is our favorite planets array. Okay, we are happy that now we are able to mutate the array indexes. Now what if I wanted to mutate a particular string, a particular character? Okay, so what I'm trying to do is favorite planet 0, so favorite planet 0 dot concat 2. So what I was expecting that, okay, it will give me the Mars 2, Saturn and Earth, but when I try to log it, I'm still holding the same value, right? So but we learned earlier that the concat doesn't actually work, so we get no change even in the compound types. So we are actually in the compound types, we are trying to mutate a primitive value. So it will still have the same value. Rest is all about objects, like you create an object and you can actually mutate a particular value. That is true, this can be done. Life discovered Mars, you just make it true and the new output will be Earth true, Mars true and Titan false. Okay, so this is just a little bit about mutability in the primitives and mutability in the compound types.